I know why you guys came here already. Y'all want to know how I did that, effect on the last tutorial? I got you. So, you see my screen. I'm not really gonna make it again. It's hard to do that. I just freestyle when I edit, I just do whatever. So I'm just break it down and teach you how I did the effect. So, the first thing you want to look at right now is these two adjustment layers, these things. Because, look, I'll show you right now. Boom. It gets rid of that little pixelized effects screen thingy. This is just the signal VHS. It adds those little lines here. Right there. Rise the brightness on your phone if you can't really see it. My bad. But yeah, so these. So the first layer here we did. A little do a little zoom in post. You can see I use signal. Here's the signal effects. That's all I changed. You can copy that if you want. Hopefully, quality is good enough. Yeah, you can pause it if you want, Go for the VHS settings, what I used. Posterize times to make it 15 to just match the scene, You don't see a VHS being like 60, 30, you know what I mean? Like, it's just for the little effect, aesthetic effect. So once you turn that all on, I'll show you right now. The seed with just the signal on. I don't have to turn off posterized time. You're not gonna see that, but yeah. So uni VHS makes it a bit darker. It has that grainy feel to it, if you know what I mean. It's like pretty grainy, dark, little glow on it, And as you can tell, I turned off most of the VHS settings because we don't want to look like a VHS. You want to look like a CRT. I don't even know what the fuck that means, bro. Okay. I have to search that up, but here, signal does most of the work, gives you that little modulation thing, if you feel me, And then the second layer is just this. This is the secret. I forgot which YouTube video I saw that added this, but I just added it to my workflow. But I'm gonna link that down in the comments, so I don't want to steal from him. I'll throw my credits and shit like that, you know what I mean? So, but I tweaked it a bit here. So let's turn these off. With just the BCC LED, you can tell with the mix with the original. If I didn't turn that on, look, it's 57. If it's at zero, it's too harsh. I don't like that. So around 50% ish is good, You can still see it, not as well. And then if you zoom in, this is from the video itself that I saw. I will link it in the description. It'll show off more of the actual steps, but here's the settings I used. You can tell it looks more like the Valorant thing, the one map. You can see the individual RGB like things on it. That's what you want to get, basically. So after that, it's just deep glow. If you don't have deep glow, you can use it with a normal glow. You just gotta play around with the radius and the brightness. Here's my settings. You don't want to add too much. Oh, that's good. You know what I mean? That's perfect. And now we want to get into how I got the OG clips to look like that. Oh, my bad. So we'll go into the composition that I used here. So for this, you can tell it's literally just this. I did nothing on here. These are just literally. Here, let me show you a better way to explain this. The top layer here is just that color effect. If I turn off the hue or the blend modes. If you're gonna try this style, mess around with the blend modes. Definitely. You can tell this is really just a Datamosh clip. And there should be plenty more. I don't know how to explain this. I literally just watched the tutorial. I'll link one down too. Really helpful that I used. So hopefully it should be good. But you know what I mean? I don't want to update it. So Datamosh. What I used was Sour Diesel and turned this to like 23, 20. Something lower, maybe. Depends on how your clip looks. You want to adjust with your clip, not just mine. You don't want to follow my, like, fully my, effect settings. Because sometimes my clip's too dark, I want to make it look brighter. If it's too light, I want to make it look dimmer. So make sure you change that up on yourself. I don't want you to just copy it, but put the stuff you learned into your own work, you know what I mean? So it doesn't look like you just slapped it on there like that, if you know what I mean? Yeah, so after that, You can see all the little glitchy effects from the Datamosh. And you're like, it's good as is, but I don't like how blocky it looks. So I just turn it into hue, which gives you that effect of like the screens like breaking down-ish. You can see here. But all I did to make this is I just took my base edit with no effects, just the base clips, like Datamosh the whole thing, put on top, a hue on it. You can mess it around with it too. You can put saturation if you want. See, this looks good too. Just depends on your clip. I like the hue more because it appears more, if you know what I mean. Like, see, it pops out more. Yeah, that's a good effect. That's one effect I used, and you can use that too. It's pretty good. And then I can show you more of how I did the most, like the complex ones, like here. I can show you more in the beginning. This one, like here, I can show you this one right here. Perfect. Oh yeah, also for the hand, this hand right here pops up. This is all through the other layer that I made without the hue. It'll look kind of messy. It will look a lot more different. But if I added the hue, it adds like that second layer on top of it. Kind of nice, you know what I mean? So let's get into this part. Get into the better frame. There you go. I go into it. So this is what we got. Let's start off with the beginning. Beginning layer. Pretty much just the basic edit. Base edit by itself. No Datamosh. Just it as is. Add another layer. I just duplicated it. Yeah. Okay, I duplicated it and then I got this effect. And you're like, how do you do that? So I put it, let's put on normal first. It looked like this on normal. This is the stuff I added. Time warp RGB gives that more. Here, let me show you. See, it's just white for now. Pretty bland, you know. Modulation, here's my settings. Copy that if you like. Time warp settings, copy that if you like. These are literally just two things I added. And then I made this overlay so it's not too hard on the edit. So see as it kind of blends in more. You know what I mean? So how it's darker here, just not a lot of stuff on it. But on the lighter parts, there's more of that little glitch effect. You can see here too. Then after that, we'll add another layer. Duplicate it again. This effect is just like making blend in more. So if I turn this off, it's just a normal thing, right? It's basic base edit, the first layer. But once I added this, it got rid. Like it blended it more, if you know what I mean. See it? Without, you can still see those little grainy stuff in the dark. Here, right here. Why am I pointing like I can. Bro. Yeah, you can see right there. It just makes it blend more. You can change this too. Make it do more, or do less. You can do more like this. See, it shows up more. All up to you. But that's how I did that little modulation effect. And you can change the colors, like if you want. Use colorama or something like that. Pretty chill, pretty chill. Here's the basically my intro scene that I made. It's basically just all like you know you can see it right here. It's all blending modes. It's all just play around with those layered on top. This is just time warp RGB. It's literally just what you learned on the other one. It's what I did here. But let me teach you more cool little glitchy stuff I did here. See without it's like that. With it's like this. So, bro looks so dumb, bro. What the heck? First thing you want to do is use extract. Let me turn off the base layer. You can change it all if you like. You can add more of him, less of him, you know what I mean? But I like to make it like outlines. You can use S underscore, like the outline one, the edge detect. You can use that too if you like. I like extract more because I have more, you know, control over how dark and how light stuff I want to take out. So I like this a lot. Play around, see, I only have a little bit, so I can just show just a bit. And the stuff I'm showing right now is the only stuff that's getting, you know, changed. I like turning off my first layer for this because I can't really see it. It's on. Turn it off. You can see what I'm working with. Hue saturation. You want to see the settings? There you go. It's pretty easy. Just change it up in the first, like the first keyframe. I just put it to zero. The last keyframe, put it to three, and just spun it around like that. You know what I mean? After that. Put up the saturation so you can see more. Picks, dither, optional. You can use mosaic if you like. It's just a more, it makes it more pixelized. You can tell right there. Without, with, without, with. It makes it more thicker. More pixelized, basically. Here's the settings, by the way. Here you go. Copy that if you like. Let's go back to the other part. Oh, sh. Shit. And that goes back on. These are just text, sea saturation, my little tag that I made. Adjustment layers just for the RGB. You can't really see it when it's still. These are just other layers that I put, like hue and stuff like that. I mean, just play around with it. You'll get what you want. Then for these, let's go to this one right here. This one, same thing. See, extract, but with modulation, time warp. There you go. Just pause if you need. Pretty easy. You chill. Without is this. With is this. And you're probably like, what's that line there? Did you make that yourself? Nah, that was glitchify. Glitchify and time warp. Without time warp? Like that. Too bland. The white like thing under. I don't want it like that. Add some color onto it. Bang. Perfect. And you get that little look, you know what I mean? These are just the basic little effects that you can add, you know. These are the same. This one's the same thing. Go into it, extract, modulation, time warp. It's pretty chill. Then you turn on the big effects here. Go up with this. Now, this is your complete little final product. As you can tell on this one, really, like, I had to see the curves. Without the curves, if I didn't brighten it, it would only look like this. So if you're running into this kind of like trouble or problem, add curves on your base layer and just bump it up, or brightness. I don't really know. Just bump it up, bump the lightness up, the brightness up. Then you'll get what you want. You know what I mean? Now you can see more. You can actually see his freaking body here. Without this, you can even see it. You can like not properly. Now you can. So I did do that too for most of them. Add a little bit of curves like this one at the end. Here, let me show you. So adding that two stuff right there, the two adjustment layers, will make your clip a lot darker. You gotta keep that in mind as you're editing. Like here, I didn't want to make this part a little more dark when I added those little glitch effects. I can show you how I did that too. So same thing, to be honest, it's just extract, glitchify, modulation, time warp, RGB. You get this basically, but make sure you just play around with the settings and you'll be fine. Be chilling. Go back to it. So yeah, after that, that's what you get. Pretty cool, huh? And you get that cool rainbow effect from the little hue I added. See, I added on top. Oh my god. But yeah, it's pretty good. And I got render queue there. This. So after that, I can show you this one neat trick you can do. I'm sure you've probably seen this in the different ones. Because here, let me show you what I added.